Hello, Jenny.
Oh, Mr. and Mrs. Crowe.
Please tell me you have the veal piccata tonight. Just the thought of it has kept me going all day.
I'm sorry, but I can't seat you.
Oh, you're not overbooked again.
Well, I see our usual table is empty. I don't know who you promised it to, but they should have gotten here sooner.
Here we are, my darling.
Thank you. Anyway, I've been trying to talk to Tommy in the hospital, but I can't seem to get through to him. It's bizarre.
Sorry, darling, is it my imagination or are people staring at
me? I'm wearing Givenchy. They always stare when I wear Givenchy.
No, I think actually they're just staring at me.
You're right. It must be your jacket. I told you plaid is over.
Mr. and Mrs. Grove.
Oh, Henry, how lovely to see you.
I'm terribly sorry, but I'm afraid I have to ask you to leave.
Oh, for God's sake, you can take the jacket off.
What's wrong?
Someone should have notified you. Your membership to the club has been revoked.
You can't be serious.
The committee met this afternoon. The vote was unanimous.
What? We've belonged to this club for 15 years. Why on earth would you want to kick us out?
It's because I'm ill, isn't it?
We have to protect our members.
It's a sexually transmitted disease. You don't get it by sharing a fucking tennis court.
All the same, your membership contract has a morals clause.
Oh. Of all the people here, you think we're the ones who lack morals? Mason Reed over there is addicted to heroin, and Susan Pong is sleeping with her brother-in-law.
And you don't want to know what happens in the club sauna.
That's not helpful.
For the last time, Mr. and Mrs. Grove, please go.
Shall we?
Would you mind terribly?
Thank you.
Goodbye, Henry.
Good for you, dear. Oh, don't worry, Henry. I'm gonna drink mine.